To welcome the August gathering and to begin the proceedings, we have our principal and chairperson of Impetus 2022, Dr. E.S.J. Prabhukiran. Sir, may I request you to kindly deliver the welcome address.
Good morning. Respected Director, Reverend Father Richard Aloysius Coelho, Reverend Father Roshan Krasta, our administrator, Chief Guest, Dr. Professor Satish Kumar Bhandari, Vice Chancellor, Inte University, Vice Principal, Dr. Vilma Mira D'Souza, Organizing Secretary, Dr. Vivek Shaktidharan, members of the Advisory Committee, members of the Management Committee, faculty and delegates, and dear students, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to this 25th Annual National Homeopathy Conference, Impetus 2022. Ever since 1880, Father Muller Charitable Institutions have been serving the sick and the suffering with the motto heal and comfort. Today, FMCI, with the number of healthcare institutions, serves as a citadel of healthcare, medical education and research where, be it patients, professionals or students, come with an assurance that they will get what they hoped for. Guiding all at FMCI, we have in our director a humane person and a visionary. I welcome you, fathers, to this inaugural program, and I request Dr. Vivek Shaktidharan, Organizing Secretary of Impetus 2022, welcome with floral bouquet. It is my pleasure to introduce our chief guest, Professor Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari, Vice Chancellor, NITE deemed to be university. Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari was born in a prestigious family of Ira Bavabidu at Ira village in Dakshina Kannada district on 14th September 1955 to Mrs. Gopi S. Bhandari and Herur Sadashiva Bhandari. He had his primary education at Ira Primary School, high school education at Kurnad Higher Primary School, and pre-university education at St. Aloysius College, Mangaluru. Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari started his academic journey in Mysore Medical College, from where he graduated, followed by diploma and then post-graduation in ENT from JJ Medical College, Davangere in 1986. After serving a distinguished academic career of 28 years, Sir was appointed as Vice Dean and served as in that capacity for a period of 5 years. Currently, he is Vice Chancellor at NITE deemed to be university since 10th November 2017. He held a long list of executive or non-executive posts such as President of Indian Medical Association South Kannada Branch, President of All India Association of Otolaryngologists of India Karnataka Chapter. He immensely contributed to the advancement of his branch through numerous national and international publications and lectures. Dr. Bhandari has initiated several new programs in patient care and healthcare delivery to rural areas, which includes Grama Kshema, NITE Smart Village Project, Kshema Sandhya, Health University Initiative, and NITE Seva Dal. He vastly contributed to research and has received external research grants of more than 30 lakhs from Baba Research Nuclear Science Government of India for his research on radioprotective activity of phytoceuticals. Dr. Bhandari is involved in many extension and social causes and was instrumental in establishing Mangalore Laryngectomy Club at K.S. Hegde Medical Academy, Mangalore. He is the recipient of various honors and awards, the most prestigious one being fellowship at UNDEM FRCS from Derek Anderson, President, Royal College of Surgeons of England, during his convocation held at St. George Hall in October 2018. He was awarded Aryabhatta Award, Distinguished Alumni Award, Eminent Educationist Award, Samaj Ratna in Medicine, Saurabha Ratna Award, and Achievement Award. to name a few. He was also given Lifetime Achievement Award by Association of Otolaryngologists of India, Karnataka chapter. Sir has 83 publications and has attended more than 80 national and international conferences and has more than 25 presentations at the conferences and scientific meetings all over the world. He has authored 2 books, one, a collection of rare medicinal plants of coastal Karnataka. It is about the collection of medicinal plants in this region. Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari also has 1 patent to his credit. He was instrumental in inaugurating Sakura Science Forum at Inite University. Having heard Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari during the inauguration of Cellomics Lab at Nitte in association with Miyazaki University, I am convinced that Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari is a great motivation for all at Nitte and also can give his inputs in research and give us opportunities as a homeopathic medical college in research forum. Sir, I am happy to welcome to you to this program. And I request Dr. Vilma D'Souza, Vice Principal, to welcome sir with a floral bouquet. I welcome our administrator who inspires us in our activities and motivates us in whatever we do. We see a constant change and growth in the institution under his leadership. I welcome you, Father, to this program. I welcome our Vice Principal, Dr. Vilma Meera D'Souza, who looks after the every detail of all activities in the college. Welcome, dear Dr. Vilma. Homeopathic conference is an academic venture of the faculty and students of Father Muller's Homeopathic Medical College, has been going on every year since 1997, except for the break given by COVID. This year, we have Impetus 2022, which showcases young research, at the same time gives us to share our experiences and learn from our seniors. To put this theme into practice and to lead all the faculty in the college, we have Dr. Vivek Shaktidharan as our organizing secretary of this Impetus 2022. Dr. Vivek, I'm very happy to welcome you to this program. I welcome our medical superintendent, Dr. Girish Nawada. I welcome the management committee members and members of the faculty. A special welcome to Dr. Urban D'Souza, Dean of Father Muller Allied Health Institute of Health Science, Allied Health Sciences. Welcome to you, sir. I also welcome our resource person of today, Dr. Shekhar Algundi. Sir, thank you for consenting to be a resource person and welcome you to you, sir. I welcome Dr. Shiv Prasad, Principal, Yenupai Homeopathy Medical College, and Dr. I acknowledge the presence of Dr. Itagi from Yenupai Homeopathy Medical College, Dr. S.K. Tiwari, and Dr. Amina Mir from Udupi. I also welcome all the delegates from internal and external to this program. A special welcome to electronic and print media front, while I thank you for your coverage, and I welcome a special welcome to you all, each one of you. I especially welcome the alumni who are attending this program and who will be with us for the next 3 days. Welcome to each one of you, and wish you a learning experience over these 2 days of Impetus 2022. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for those warm words of welcome.
We were called out of the darkness into his marvelous light. Light signifies knowledge, commitment for a new beginning. As we witness to quest for the knowledge, Let us now formally inaugurate Impetus 22 symbolically by lighting the lamp. May I now request our chief guest, Professor Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari, to do the honor. I also request the dignitaries on the dais and also Dr. Anjali, our first registered delegate, to kindly join for the lighting the lamp. Thank you all. Kindly be seated.
We are all ears, heart and mind as we eagerly wait to hear from our chief guest, Professor Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Nitte Deralakatte, Mangaluru.
Very good morning to each one of you gathered here. Thank you, Dr. Prabhu Kiran, for the lavish introduction. Thank you very much. Presiding officer of today's very momentous occasion, Reverend Father Richard Aloysius Coelho, the director, Father Muller's Charitable Institutions, principal of Father Muller's Homeopathic Medical College, Dr. Prabhu Kiran, very dynamic organizing secretary of this conference, Dr. Vivek Shaktidharan, the Vice Principal Wilma D'Souza, the administrator of Father Miller's Homeopathic Medical College, Reverend Father Roshan Kasta, very distinguished resource persons. I don't want to name them, but I want to recognize the presence of Professor Dr. Tiwari, who has substantially contributed for homeopathy in the city of Mangalore. Very distinguished delegates who have come from far and wide, from various homeopathic medical colleges of the country, invitees, dear students, members of the press, and ladies and gentlemen, I'm extremely happy to be part of this very momentous occasion, the inaugural function of Impetus 2022. Understand, a very historical occasion, 25th annual conference of homeopaths of India. I should congratulate both the delegates, and I should congratulate the Father Muller's Homeopathic Medical College principal and vice principal and all faculty, very distinguished faculty are there in Homeopathic Medical College. I should congratulate them for organizing this meeting. This moment has become very special because we are assembling, I think, for the last 2 years, I don't know whether we organized conference in a physical form. We are all, I think the MC said, we are all in a new mode, but we are slowly returning back to the normalcy, and we are having this wonderful occasion of meeting our friends, colleagues, alma mater, teachers. I think most of you are probably alumnus of this Homeopathic Medical College. I understand this is one among the first homeopathic college in the country, could be. But I think this has got a long history of, I'll talk about that later. But anyway, this is one of the oldest homeopathic medical college in this part of the world. And naturally, a lot of students must have gone out of these portals of this institution. I'm sure that all the delegates, I think I understand that more than 500 delegates have registered for this conference. I assure you that you will have very fruitful conferencing in Mangalore. For two reasons. One is Father Muller's Homeopathic Medical College hosting that, and you are in the city of Mangalore. As you all know, conferences are meant for, yes, academic deliberations, but also for exchanging ideas and very important aspect, networking. Because nowadays we talk about a lot of networking. You talk to your leaders, you talk to your colleagues who are, I think there may be stalls, instruments and dealers of various medicines. And we'll be talking to a lot of people, a lot of other institutions. Now with the collaboration is the norm. Unless you collaborate and do networking, nothing grows. So that should be very, very important part of this conference, along with academics. And also exploring places in and around Mangalore. And also experiencing the good food. I think Mangalore is known for a lot of things. I think all of you know that Mangalore is the pioneer in banking. You might have heard about Syndicate Bank, started long back. And we have got a very distinguished position of hosting four nationalized banks. And all of them probably, you know that they merged with other banks. We lost our identity. But the people who have brought banking are Mangaloreans or South Canara people. Those days we had undivided district. We had Udupi and Mangalore. Now we are two. We are one, culturally, socially, we are one. But banking, and you know that hospitality industry is, you know, Mangalore is the pioneer, again in hospital industry. Wherever you go, you see Udupi hotels. Where you go to Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore, wherever you go, even New York, or if you go to Japan, I had gone to Japan, or I went to Europe, many places. We look for our Mangalore hotels, and even though cooks may be from Nepal or other places, the people, entrepreneurs are from Mangalore. So that is the very important character of this area. Basically, we are entrepreneurs. Mangaloreans are entrepreneurs. That's what we should, I think all of you doctors should be entrepreneurs also. We should be job givers than the job seekers. So that is very, very important. Yes, there is a satisfaction by having your own clinic, but you also should employ or give jobs to others. So that's an entrepreneurship. That's again, it is there in the blood of Mangaloreans. And educational institutions. I think in this road itself, we have got three universities. We have got Mangalore. I think even now, in the future, Father Mullah's also become a university. We hope that Father Mullah's becomes, it has got all the potential to become a university, one wonderful university. I always admire Father Mullah's Medical College and institution, Father institutions, I really like the way that you kept the campus, how you received us, the guests, the whole process is so systematic. Garlanding the Muller and then the homeopath who brought homeopathy to the world, all that was so systematic. Thank you very much. And hospitality you have given to me. This is what we should learn from institutions. Always I admire. In my institution, I will say, always in any meeting, I will quote Father Muller's institutions. So systematic. I like this atmosphere. So Mangalore is known for medical institutions. There are, we got 9 institutions, nowhere in the world, in such a small place. Our population may be around 6-7 lakhs, but we will show 10 lakhs. Or including all the villages. But we have got 9 medical colleges here. And homeopathic medical college and many Ayurvedic medical colleges. Name any institution is there in Mangalore. Starting from fashion technology to every name, any institution, any that's there in Mangalore. And it's become an education hub. And we attract a lot of students from all over the country. So that's again an important thing. And we have got nice beaches. Is known for temples, it is known for chapel, churches, it is known for dargahs. So you got lot of things to do in the next, I don't know how many days you are staying here. After 2 days conference, you extend your stay for one more day. Visit all these places, I mean, a very nice relaxation after this COVID pandemic. We call it Vishwa Guru. It has taught us a lot of lessons. Now it has become a guru for us, Vishwa Guru, and we know now where we stand. Our egos all have disappeared now, because we know that we are nothing in front of any calamity or any man, God-given curse or anything, whatever you call it. But yeah, as a scientist or as a doctors, we know that it's a treatable condition. But you know how we are taken for a ride during those 2 years. We didn't know what to do. So after this, all that calamity, all that problems, now we are back to normalcy. I hope you will take this opportunity to explore both academics and entertainment. One more important, this in a lighter vein, we have done a lot of things to world. You may be knowing that Miss World is given from Mangalore. You may be knowing, all of you may be knowing, very familiar with Aishwarya Rai. She is from Mangalore. We have given Mr. World, I think he is from Fatherless Institutions. Raymond D'Souza. He's a Mr. World is from Mangalore. In a lighter vein, you have given many underworlds also. Mangalore, we have got underworlds. So we are very multifaceted people. So you should recognize Mangaloreans as a special breed of people in this committee of world. The one more important thing what I missed is homeopathy is given to India by Father Muller's institutions. Because always you miss some very important, because that's why when I was going through the waters first in Mangalore, then I thought, Father Muller's, that you know that institution of started for 142 years back. See the legacy of Father Muller's institution. 142 years, Father Muller, Father Augustus Muller, he came to Mangalore, and I was told he was a teacher and also he was a doctor, he was a homeopath. He had learned homeopathy in Germany, and he came with a lot of love for the people and also with a lot of homeopathic medicines he brought from Germany and started treating people. Those days, you imagine 142 years back, what will be the status of treatment? There is no treatment for tuberculosis, there is no treatment for leprosy, infectious disease, smallpox, how people used to die. Those days, it was a beacon of hope, a person coming and treating patient, particularly leprosy patient those days. I am very grateful to Father Muller's Medical College for treating such diseases, tuberculosis and leprosy. Leprosy is mainly, that was a main, and dermatological diseases. I think Father Muller is known for all those, and even now it is very popular for treating these conditions. So again, homeopathy is a gift to this nation by Father Muller's institutions. I understand Homeopathy Medical College, which was started a little later, now imparting education for undergraduate, postgraduate, and it's running a hospital here. And very important, one point I failed to impress on you is the homeopathy drugs are manufactured in this campus. I am really happy that because manufacturing drugs is also very important, quality drugs. So I think when this particular aspect of preparing homeopathic medicines, I think all factors are taken into account, and I'm very happy to tell you that the drugs are manufactured and exported to other countries from this place. So that's additional facility. I think the delegates can visit that place where it's how it's manufacturing unit. So you'll have interaction with the industry also. So again, this is another advantage of having conference here. You can have both aspects. One is manufacturing of the drugs. You can have industry interaction. You can look at the how it is being manufactured and how it is dispensed and all those things. So this is another very important aspect of this homeopathic medical college and advantage of having contrast this campus. Father Muller's institutions, I think they are primarily involved not only here, they are involved in, as you all know, the medical education, nursing education. Again, nursing is very, very specialty of Father Muller's medical college, and people are always quote the nursing care given in the Father Muller's medical college. All these things are, I'm talking positive things what you can get from an institution, because that should be our this thing. Because we are in the neighborhood, we envy the things, and we should get the positive things. Always we should learn from others, others' mistakes as well as their positive things. That's what should be the goal or the aim of your person. And you should not be envious, you should not be talking ill about others. You talk positive things about others. That is one of the noble qualities what we should do, and I am very happy that Father Muller institutions are doing great job. They are doing yeoman service to mankind, humanity in this part of the world. And I was talking to the principal that he said he was interested in research also. Because I'm not going to talk about homeopathy because it's not my forte, and I'm not going to, because there is a lot of controversies. When allopath talks about the thing, he's got his own reservations about the modality of treatment in homeopathy. There are arguments for and against homeopathy, and what I call it, similarity principle. What I understand, what you follow is the similarity principle. And there are a lot of people who contradict or they got difference of opinion about that. But I'm not going to touch upon that, because talk about evidence-based medicine. Always we talk about evidence-based medicine. But many times we fail to give evidence for medicine as well as the cure, how the patients get cured. There are people, they say, I had cancer and I was treated, I went there, here and there. Even biopsy was ruled, not in India, even other countries. They say, somehow, miraculous, I got cured. I became all right. There are many conditions. Particularly in homeopathy, I got few of my relatives who go for homeopathy treatment for chronic dermatological conditions. In our allopathic treatment, we offer everything, and most of them steroid-based ointments will be there. Sometimes when the diagnosis is very, very vague, they get this thing. But when they don't have other hopes of getting any other treatment, I have seen they are going for alternative treatment, maybe homeopathy, Ayurveda, Siddha, or Unani, or any other alternative medicines. But they find relief. And there is a debate saying that whether the medicine is a science or art. Most of the people in olden days, they said it's more of art than the science. But slowly the concept is changing. Yes, it's a science. It's a science. It's a both art and science. According to me, medicine is both art and science. It's not only science, it's also art. So why we say that it's a art? Sometimes see some of the students very, very mediocre, very poor background during their studies. Sometimes they fail many times, and we condemn them that they may not do well in their career. Today I see them doing exceedingly well in practicing medicine. Some have become extraordinary people. And we thought they'll not do well in their professional practice. What makes them different? Because their knowledge, if you see, they may not do well. They may not treat patients well. But when they go to private practice, when they do treat patients, they become really good doctors. Then what makes them a good doctor? Their art of medicine, they know how to treat the patients. So art of medicine is totally different from knowledge you acquire in medical colleges. Art of medicine, most of the time we don't teach them in the medical colleges. Most of them, because we are for marks. What is the formative assessment? How many marks has got an internal assessment? Is eligible for appearing with examination? Many fail to get into, even take the examination because they failed in internal assessment marks. Or attendance, that's again a big problem in the medical colleges. They don't come for the class, they come late, they miss the morning class. Once they miss the class, next day also they don't come. Because the teacher asks why you didn't come previous day. So I have seen a few of my colleagues from Mysore Medical College, they left the medical college. Because our anatomy head of the department, you may be knowing, she became vice chancellor later. She was very, very tough. And most of the people, they discontinued the course. Most of the sense, few of them, particularly from this part of the world. Because they started missing classes in the beginning, and they were irregular, and they stopped attending classes. Finally, they left hopes, and they were rotting there for years together. So this can happen. So art of medicine, we sometimes don't teach. But art of medicine is very, very important for a doctor, whether it's a allopathy doctor or homeopathic doctor or Ayurveda doctor. But I'm always see the people with alternate medicine, they have got better approach to the patients. Probably that makes you more a distinct category of doctors because your approach is totally different. You talk about their diet, their exercise, their food habits, you've got time to extract history. You don't go by the investigations. You go by the personal approach to the patient. So that makes you distinct. So what makes a doctor, not only his professional or academic knowledge, what is very, very important is soft skills. You should have good communication skill. You should have good listening power. You should listen to the patient. Sometimes what we do not have time. When you're seeing many patients, you will not have time to listen to the patient. But you should be, forget all the pathies. It may be allopathy, homeopathy, or orthopathy. What is important is sympathy and empathy. That is very, very important for the doctor. If you are empathetic to the patient, I think he'll get half the disease will be cured. Always the patients, because I'm also a practicing ENT surgeon. Patients come, sir, after coming to you, after listening to you, we felt better, we became better. What is that factor? They say the healing touch is also very important for a doctor. So all these things are very important, along with the professional knowledge. I think this is being imparted in this homeopathic medical college, and I hope this message will be taken by the delegates who are here, and also it will be reflected in all the talks of the distinguished resource persons. Always inculcate values among our students, values among our citizens, values both, it applies to the patients also. So this is very, very important, and the principal is talking about research. I think in homeopathy also, I don't know what is the level of research you are doing. We should not hesitate because let us find out what is the truth behind some certain form of treatment. Because even now we are doing a lot of things. The music therapy sometimes we say. And as a head of the department of ENT, I started in my ward music therapy to the patients. And I wanted to see the pain threshold after the surgery. I did find a change. The pain threshold increased and the perception of pain decreased. They are feeling better. Again, what type of music? Is it soothing music or is it a jazz or a high-level, high-decibel music? It's always the instrumental music. We can study. Definitely there is evidence. When the plant cells itself, they become different, they can change, their yield improves by music. What about the human beings? So such things, even yoga now, or meditation, all that can complement the existing system of medicine. It may be allopathy, it may be homeopathy or Ayurveda. So we should always get the knowledge, not only from our system of medicine, we should get from other systems, other ways of treatment so that you can improve the quality of life, particularly quality of life. When we talk about chronic illnesses, non-communicable diseases like cancer or autoimmune diseases, I think there's a role for, I always see, autoimmune diseases, allergy. Homeopaths are doing well in this particular area because even allopathy, we don't have much to offer sometimes. We do, and finally, we take the shelter of steroids in the form of sprays and other things. But a lot of other things are there. Even naturopathy is giving a lot of complementary support for allopathic treatment because always food, exercise, way of life, stress, all these things play both in originating disease, as also perpetuating the disease and also decreasing your life expectancy. So all these things will be taken care. This can be the important aspects of a research, what we can do. You can have a collaboration. I think you should not hesitate collaborating with allopathy. If the college is interested in doing some research on particular areas like this, autoimmune diseases or it may be in allergic disease, we are willing to participate. We are willing to collaborate. We can have memorandum of understanding because so near, I think these two institutions are so near. I'll be more than eager to participate in this collaborative research because I'm very much interested in collaborative research because about 2-3 years back, in my village, I found one particular bark in my family house. There's a one plant. They were removing the bark and treating the people. I came to know that in one particular house, they are giving medicine for cancer. And they were attracting patients from a lot of outsiders also used to come, even from Bombay and other cities. They used to come for treatment. Then I found this particular plant had become totally denuded. They had removed the bark continuously. We never used to object they're using for treatment. Then I wanted to find out what is there in that bark. Then I got to know that it is called Orozylum indicum. That plant is called Orozylum indicum. And we took the bark and then we did animal studies in our laboratory. We got molecular and cytogenetics laboratories are there. Even animal house is a good animal house. So we did cellular changes with this particular bark extract. Ethanol and extracts were taken from this particular bark of that plant. Then we got interaction with the Miyazaki University. They got a good lab there and I sent the extract to even Miyazaki University in Japan. And now we have found that it is as good as one of the good anti-cancer molecule, as good as anti-cancer molecule. But what is the delivery of this particular, because what they give in Ayurveda cannot be replicated in the form of tablets or capsules because we are giving in extracts. So how to transform? Because always the bioavailability of this particular extract and in the form of tablets is totally different. So now we are working on that. That's being patented also. So these are things like we did on pomegranate plant. It's another patent I got for oral mucositis on patients who are having cancer and who are getting radiation, and radiation causes destruction of the normal cells and they go for mucositis. For them, we are giving, we are preparing now a mouthwash where they can gargle and they can get relieved of the mucositis. So these are the things that when a practicing ENT person can do, think of such things, I think you brilliant 500 delegates and the students of Homeopathic Medical College have got very bright future if you put your ideation. And nowadays, you know that startups have come up in a big way. All the colleges should encourage students in getting ideations and proof of concept and converting into startup companies. So these are the things or avenues you have got apart from your homeopathic practice. With this, a few words. I thank once again for Homeopathy Medical College, the principal, vice principal, and all other administrators of Father Muller's Homeopathy Medical College for giving me this opportunity to be part of this conference. I hope the doctors will become lifelong learners. We advise the students, you should be lifelong learners. What about us? We, the teachers, also should be lifelong learners, both academics and in research. So this type of conference always will help you to hone your skills and get involved and get interact with the senior colleagues, very distinguished resource persons. I think it will help you in becoming experts in certain areas and becoming can rejuvenate your experiences professionally. I hope Impetus 22 will make a lasting impact in all of you, both academically, and you'll have very pleasant memories to carry from this conference. Wish you all the best. May God bless you.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable words of guidance and enlightenment.
Souvenir is a memoir of all the best moments of Impetus 22, thoroughly revised and engraved with perfection to bring you back your feel-good snippets of the conference. May I now request our chief guest, Professor Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari, to release the souvenir of Impetus 22. Thank you, sir, for doing the honors.
Innovation and empathy are the two wheels on which our homeopathic pharmaceutical division treads on. Today, under the able leadership of Reverend Father Roshan Krasta, HPD is spreading its wings to a new span. Now, I request our administrator, Reverend Father Roshan Krasta, to begin the proceedings of new product launch. Over to you, Father.
Good morning, everyone. Respected Director, Father Muller Charitable Institutions, Professor Dr. Satish Kumar Bhandari, the chief guest of the program, and dignitaries on the days of the days, and my dear friends. When I heard the speech message from the chief guest, already mentioned about the importance of Father Muller's Homeopathy Medical College, also the pharmaceutical division he mentioned. And I'm very happy that he knows more than me about the history of Father Muller's. It's wonderful to know, yes, sir. And today we are very happy to launch the varieties of Shalom prickly powder. Shalom is one of the very famous powders in homeopathy section, and today we are here to launch different improved version of different colors and fragrances. So with the tagline for instant cooling and healing, so with different colors, and we are bringing up today smaller pack also, 50 gram pack. Not only Shalom powder but also Zero Pain, one of the famous balm in homeopathy we have around here, and today we are launching bigger 50 gram package also. So I request our production manager to join with us, Mr. Ratan Kumar, and also I request our director and chief guest to join with us to launch these different improved versions of Shalom and Zero Pain. Yes. We'll be right back.
Thank you, Father. Father, we also request you to deliver your message on this occasion.
So, this may not be a speech because they're going to be resource persons. We'll talk about different topics for which you are attending the program. And these, sample is the offer is there. You can collect later in our stall for 50 rupees, Shalom powder. And this is for the handsome guys and beautiful, charming faces. You don't require, but you can use this Shalom for the graceful faces. And that definitely will help you to be more graceful. So I thank Mr. Ratan Kumar and entire staff of Father Mulla Pharmaceutical Division. And also I thank Father Rohan Dias, who was my assistant last year, for initiating this work. So with conclude my message, Impetus 2022, kindle the process to success on different topics that we are going to deliberate today. So I am very much grateful to Dr. Vivek Shaktidharan and entire team for their wonderful work. And I welcome the delegates, our alumni and faculty members, the students from Martin's College from Tamil Nadu, and all our other external delegates, our students, postgraduates, interns. So I welcome all of you, and also I thank the presence of former principals and our alumni and chief guests, resource persons. I also thank the media people here. Father John Voss is here. Father, I thank him and welcome him. So this is a milestone event, 25th Homeopathy Conference, 25th milestone event. And definitely this will help further deliberations in terms of research and learning experience. So conferences or seminars or continuous medical education help healthcare professionals to keep up the phase with its currents. Opportunity to directly engage with the experts, scholars, researchers, sharing the best practices and to adopt to the new skills and techniques. That is why it's very important to participate event like this. Here, by attending the conference like this, we can be acquainted with the scholars and researchers. So presentations of new ideas may open up new ways of thinking and practices. So it's very important to find the present research findings and adopt ourselves to the currents. I know you are going to be busy in practices, but updating knowledge with the currents is very, very important. And that is what we are going to do on this event. So I welcome you, all of you, once again to this campus, Father Mulla Homeopathy Medical College, here at Deralakatte. And I thank everyone being part of this wonderful conference. I thank my director for all the cooperation that he renders to us. Once again, I am grateful to him, and principal and the vice principal, everyone. So with this, I wish you all the best, all the success. Have a wonderful stay here, 2 days. And also we are having the Milan, the alumni meet tomorrow. And thereafter, I think on Sunday also we have a sports event. We are going to play together. So I wish all the success to all the events that are going to come. So thank you, and God bless you.
Thank you, Father. Father, we request you to deliver your presidential address.
Honorable Vice Chancellor of NITTE, deemed to be university, all our faculty, students, and especially delegates from all over India who have come here for this 25th National Conference Impetus 2022. Well, first I would like to thank and appreciate Dr. Bhandari, Honorable Vice Chancellor, our good neighbor, for having appreciated Padamulla Medical College and charitable institutions, and the contribution given by this institution for the last 142 years to this country and also to the globe. And also mentioning about the homeopathy, that Father Mulla is the pioneer of homeopathy in India, and that's why today we garlanded his bust, and the institution today stands in his name to continue his legacy which he began 142 years ago. Homeopathy is currently seen as top priority alternative modern medicine in India, especially this part of Karnataka and of course Kerala. In the 19th century, homeopathy became very popular in Europe and also in the States, and later also in India. But there was initially some fear, subtle fear, whether this kind of treatment will harm the human body. But later it was considered as a myth, but rather homeopathy became a very popular system of medicine today. And in the world today, after allopathy, homeopathy is the next system of medicine which is practiced and used for the treatment of the patients in the world. Maybe in India, second place is, I don't know, maybe it's going to Ayurveda after allopathy. Second place is for Ayurveda. But soon, homeopathy will become, at least it will come to the second place in India for the treatment, I feel so. Many people think that homeopathy is the treatment is of substandard rate, or the medicine is cheap, and it has no much side effects, and people go for it. As Dr. rightly said, in allopathy, more on diagnostics and also on investigations, whereas in homeopathy, more and more of individualistic, taking the case history, the family background, the food habits, and the entire psychology of the patient, it is taken as a holistic way, and then the treatment of homeopathy begins to that patient. And as Sir said rightly, for all chronic diseases, homeopathy is the right treatment today. That is what we see. I'm happy that the college for the last 25 years organizing a conference national level of this magnitude is not an easy job, except for those 2 years. And another good practice of this college is the 25th batch, the people who complete 25 years, the alumni students coming together as an entire batch to the college, and meeting, holding a meeting, and having interaction with one another. It is a very good spirit, and good to know what my companion is doing, and how things are there today. That is a very good practice. And today, for this conference, Dr. Shaktidharan has, as his name, he has shown his Shakti, though he's short. In organizing this conference, I'm really grateful to him and entire team, and under the guidance of Father Roshan. I'm sure you will have very fruitful sessions today and tomorrow to share the rich expertise of other your seniors, especially your teachers, and also for the students and interns, postgraduates, to become budding or good homeopath practitioners in the future. And may God bless all of you, and may this conference of 2 days go on well. We pray for this. God bless and all the best.
Thank you, Father, for your words of encouragement and your valuable presence. Audience to remain standing as the dignitaries recede as we come to the end of the formal inaugural program of Impetus 22.